गुड इवनिंग वंस अगेन टू ऑल ऑफ यू. इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड 3 points. इट इज द सम ऑफ मीन्स डिफरेंस बिटवीन ग्रॉस वर्किंग कैपिटल एंड नेट वर्किंग कैपिटल. इट इज द सम ऑफ ऑल करंट एसेट. इट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन करंट एसेट एंड करंट लायबिलिटी. सेकेंड पॉइंट, इट डज नॉट गिव ट्रू पिक्चर अ ट्रू आइडिया क्लियर आइडिया अबाउट द लिक्विडिटी पोजिशन ऑफ द कंपनी. वेर एज नेट वर्किंग कैपिटल गिव्स ट्रू पिक्चर ऑफ लिक्विडिटी पोजिशन ऑफ द कंपनी. Third point is, it gives clear picture or true idea about the financial position of the company. Sorry, it does not give clear picture of financial position of the company. Whereas net working capital gives true picture about the financial position of the company. Now fourth point is, increase in current liability also increases gross working capital. Increase in current liability also increases gross working capital, whereas increase in current liability does not increase net working capital. Fourth point, increase in current liability in case of gross working capital. Increase in current liability also increases gross working capital. Here, increase in current liability does not increase net working capital. How? Now take one example. Suppose right now total current asset is of 50,000. Just assume that current asset is of 50,000 and current liability is of 30,000. Current asset is 50,000, current liability is 30,000. Now what is the point? Increase in current liability. Suppose we have taken one short term loan of 10,000 plus 10,000. Increase in current liability, it becomes 40,000. So here we have taken loan in the form of cash. Cash is a current asset. So second effect, we have to add 10,000 in current asset also. It becomes 60,000. So increase in current liability, here current liability increases from 30,000 to 40,000. As a result, current asset increases from 50,000 to 60,000. So increase in current liability also increases current assets, means also increases gross working capital, because in gross working capital we are not taking difference. Gross working capital is the sum of all current asset. The sum of 50 plus 10, sum of all current asset is called gross working capital. So whenever we are taking any loan, any means whenever current liability increases, when we are taking loan of 10,000 means cash. At the same time, we have to add cash in current asset also. As a result, current asset also increases. And definition of gross working capital is, it is the sum total of only and only current asset. So increase in current liability also increases gross working capital. Second point, in case of net working capital, increase in current liability does not increase net working capital. How? Okay, put. Now increase in current liability does not increase net working capital. How? Net working capital means difference between current asset and current liability. So when we have taken loan of 10,000, at the same time current liability becomes 30 plus 10, 40,000. and at the same time current assets becomes 50 plus 10, 60,000. 60 minus 40, it becomes 20,000. So this is called net working capital. Earlier current asset 50,000, current liability 30,000, 50 minus 30, 20,000. Earlier also net working capital was 20,000. When we have taken loan of 10,000, current liability increases as well as current asset increases, and now difference is again same 20,000. It means increase in current liability, increase in current liability does not increase net working capital. Net working capital means difference of current asset and current liability, it remains same. So difference is increase in current liability also increases gross working capital, whereas increase in current liability does not increase net working capital. Now new topic is characteristics of working capital. Characteristics of working capital. Now what is the characteristics of working capital? First one is it is short term capital. This point, short term capital. Second one is components. Third one is liquidity. Fourth one is risk. Fifth one is depreciation. And sixth one is to pay day-to-day expenses. These are the characteristics of working capital: short-term capital, components, liquidity, risk, depreciation, and to pay day-to-day expenses. First one is short term capital. So we have already done in the definition of working capital that capital which is invested for short term period means capital invested on current assets and current liability. Current assets and current liabilities are utilized for short term period. So working capital is utilized or invested or circulated in the business for short time period. Now second one is components. We all know that working capital includes current assets and current liabilities. So examples of current assets and current liabilities you have to give. For example, purchase of raw material means you have to write that working capital includes purchase of raw material, purchase of fixed assets, purchase of finished goods, then debtors, bill receivable. These are the examples of working capitals. Means in components you have to give examples of all current assets and current liabilities also. Liquidity. Now liquidity means in case of working capital, liquidity is very high. Liquidity is high. High means as compared to fixed capital. Why? Liquidity is very high as compared to fixed capital. Liquidity is high of working capital as compared to fixed capital. Amount invested on fixed asset. Amount invested on fixed asset is called fixed capital. And we are purchasing fixed assets, means non-current asset, not to convert into cash immediately. We are purchasing fixed asset for a longer time of period. Means we do not want, means any business do not want to convert their fixed assets into cash. They are purchasing such fixed assets. They are investing the amount on fixed assets for longer period. Means liquidity is very less in case of fixed capital. So far as working capital is concerned, liquidity is very high, because here in case of working capital, we are investing money on current assets and current liabilities. And what is the meaning of current assets and current liabilities? The current assets means the assets which can be converted into cash easily and quickly. It means very quickly, very soon, all current assets are converted into cash, means liquid. That's why liquidity is high in case of working capital as compared to fixed capital. Liquidity is high as compared to fixed capital. Reason? Because working capital can be converted into cash easily and quickly. That's why liquidity position, liquidity proportion is high. Now risk, fourth point. Risk. So there is less risk in case of in working capital there is less risk in working capital as compared to fixed capital. Why there is less risk? The two reasons are there. One is a small proportion is invested, a small proportion of total fund is invested on working capital. And second point, working capital is, again same reason, working capital is converted into cash quickly, is converted into cash quickly, means very soon we are able to recover the amount which is invested on working capital. So one is fixed capital, other is working capital. Fixed capital means capital invested on fixed assets like land and building, plant and machinery. So whatever, and in case of fixed assets, we are investing a huge fund and for a longer time of period. For example, if we have purchased a machinery of 5 lakh rupees, and after 1 year, if technology changes, it means it brings a huge loss to the business, because they need to replace the old technology with new technology. That's why it is a great risk in case of fixed capital. But so far as working capital is concerned, we all know the nature of working capital. It is converted into cash quickly, very soon. That's why there is less risk, or proportion of risk is less, if we compare the risk of working capital with fixed capital. Then we will find that there is less risk in case of working capital. Reason is we are investing a small proportion of total fund, total available fund on working capital, and working capital is converted into cash quickly and easily. That's why there is less risk. Fifth one is no depreciation. No depreciation. Working capital is circulating in business constantly. First point, I have already told you that working capital is circulating a business constantly. Second point, its value, it means its value changes continuously. Its value changes continuously. So, depreciation cannot be charged on working capital as we are charging depreciation on fixed capital. In case of fixed capital, for example, we have purchased a machinery. The machinery we have purchased for a longer time of period. Machinery is a non-current asset, means fixed asset. And this machinery we have purchased for a longer time of period. We are using this machinery for production. That's why at the end of every year, we are evaluating, we are calculating how much value of machinery decreases. That decreased value is called depreciation. It means depreciation is charged only on non-current assets, not on working capital, because working capital circulates in business continuously. Its value changes continuously. Why its value changes continuously? Because it is converted into cash easily and quickly. That's why depreciation, we cannot charge depreciation on working capital. Sixth one is to pay day-to-day expense. So working capital is, I have already told you that working capital is used for meeting day-to-day expenses. For example, payment of wages to laborers, payment of salary to employees, payment of electricity bill, payment of raw material which we are purchasing on cash basis. So in order to fulfill, in order to meet day-to-day expenses, whatever money we are utilizing, that is called working capital. Means working capital is also utilized for fulfilling, for meeting day-to-day expenses. So one line you can write that working capital is utilized in order to pay day-to-day expenses of the business unit. So these are all characteristics of working capital. Short-term capital, we all know one line explanation, working capital is used for short-term period. In simple language you can write. Components, working capital includes current assets and current liabilities. Like, then you can give examples, few examples of current assets, few examples of current liability. For example, creditor, bill payable, debtor, bill receivable. You all know about the components of current assets and current liabilities. Liquidity is high reason working capital. In case of working capital, current assets and current liabilities are included, and current assets and current liabilities are very quickly, it is converted into cash. That's why proportion of liquidity is high in case of working capital as compared to fixed capital. Machinery, land and building, then amount invested on vehicles, we are not converting those fixed assets into cash. Risk, because here less proportion of total fund is invested. First point, less proportion, the percentage of invested amount is less in case of working capital as compared to fixed capital. So less amount is invested. Second, working capital is converted into cash very quickly. That's why the proportion of risk is also less as compared to fixed capital. No depreciation, because here working capital is circulating in business constantly. Its value changes constantly. That's why we cannot charge, means working capital is used for short term period. That's why we cannot charge depreciation on working capital. And last, to pay day to day expense, one line explanation, that working capital is utilized in order to fulfill, in order to meet day to day expenses like purchase of raw material, payment of electricity bill, payment of wages to laborers, payment of salary to employees, payment of tax to the government. In order to pay all this, in order to fulfill, in order to meet all these expenses, we have to utilize working capital. So these are the characteristics of working capital. Please take one photograph. Now, last topic related with working capital is, what are the factors that affecting working capital? What are the factors affecting working capital means? When any business unit needs more working capital and when they need less working capital. That is called factors affecting working capital. So only you have to learn points. Explanation is very, very simple. Factors affecting working capital means in which condition more working capital is required or in which condition less working capital is required. That is called factors affecting working capital. First point is, in case of factors affecting working capital, nature and type of business . Second one is size of business . Third one is production cycle. Production cycle. Fourth one is credit policy. And fifth one is operating efficiency. So you can take any 5 points of your own choice. I have taken these simple points in order to explain the factors affecting working capital. मतलब वो कौन कौन से कारण या किस किस परिस्थिति में business units के अंदर कभी ज़्यादा working capital यूज करनी पड़ती है या कभी कम वर्किंग कैपिटल यूज करनी पड़ती है. तो इन दिस रिगार्ड 5 points आर देयर. फर्स्ट वन इज नेचर एंड टाइप ऑफ बिजनेस. तो यू कैन एक्सप्लेन द नेचर एंड टाइप ऑफ बिजनेस इन 4 different ways. फर्स्ट वन इज मैन्युफैक्चरिंग यूनिट. सेकेंड वन इज ट्रेडिंग यूनिट. Third one is industries based on capital intensive production technique. And fourth one is labor intensive production technique. So very simple explanation is there. You have to explain about these 4 different types of industries. Not 4, only 2 types of industries are there: manufacturing unit and trading unit. Or means units depends on different natures. Manufacturing units वो होते हैं जो raw material खरीदते हैं, फिर इस raw material को finished goods में convert करते हैं, then supplying into the market. Trading units are such units जो ready-made goods किसी दूसरे मैन्युफैक्चरर से खरीद के दे आर सेलिंग रेडीमेड गुड्स टू कस्टमर. दैट इज कॉल्ड ट्रेडिंग यूनिट. सो इन केस ऑफ मैन्युफैक्चरिंग यूनिट्स, क्योंकि वो रॉ मटेरियल खरीदते फिर इसको फिनिश गुड्स में कन्वर्ट करते, मींस दे नीड्स टू इन्वेस्ट ह्यूज फंड्स ऑन मशीनरीज, दे नीड टू परचेज रॉ मटेरियल. दैट्स व्हाई मोर वर्किंग कैपिटल इज रिक्वायर्ड. हियर मोर वर्किंग कैपिटल इज रिक्वायर्ड. Whereas in case of trading unit, less working capital is required. Less working capital is required. बस आपको ऐसे ही explain करने का है किस परिस्थिति में working capital ज़्यादा चाहिए, किस परिस्थिति में working capital कम चाहिए. If business unit is based on capital intensive production technique. Now what is capital intensive production technique? Where machineries are used in more quantity and labors are used less. जहाँ लेबर कम और मशीनरी ज़्यादा यूज़ करते हैं, क्योंकि मशीनरी ज़्यादा यूज़ कर रहे हैं तो वी नीड टू इन्वेस्ट ह्यूज फंड ऑन सच मशीनरीज, मीन्स मोर वर्किंग कैपिटल इज रिक्वायर्ड मोर. एंड इन केस ऑफ लेबर इंटेंसिव प्रोडक्शन टेक्निक, व्हाट इज लेबर इंटेंसिव प्रोडक्शन टेक्निक? वेयर लेबर्स आर यूज मोर एज कम्पेयर टू मशीनरीज, सो हेयर लेस वर्किंग कैपिटल इज रिक्वायर्ड. इन दिस वे यू हैव टू एस्टिमेट दिस पॉइंट. वंस अगेन, पॉइंट इज नेचर एंड टाइप ऑफ बिजनेस. इन केस ऑफ मैन्युफैक्चरिंग यूनिट और मैन्युफैक्चरिंग बेस्ड यूनिट, मोर वर्किंग कैपिटल इज रिक्वायर्ड, वेयर एज इन केस ऑफ ट्रेडिंग यूनिट लेस वर्किंग कैपिटल इज रिक्वायर्ड. इफ बिजनेस यूनिट्स आर बेस्ड ऑन कैपिटल इंटेंसिव प्रोडक्शन टेक्निक, इन दैट केस मोर वर्किंग कैपिटल इज रिक्वायर्ड. इफ बिजनेस यूनिट्स आर बेस्ड ऑन लेबर इंटेंसिव प्रोडक्शन टेक्निक, इन दैट केस लेस वर्किंग कैपिटल इज रिक्वायर्ड. तो एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज कंप्लीटेड. Now size of business, very simple. Size of business, large size and small size. So if business unit is of large sized, then more working capital is required, simple explanation. And if business unit is of small size, then less working capital is required. Complete. Production cycle. Now production cycle is that time period, or is the time period between, production cycle is the time period between the arrangement it is the time period between the arrangement of raw material and conversion of raw material into finished goods. Once again, production cycle is the time period, between the arrangement of raw material and conversion of raw material into finished goods is called production cycle. Now, first of all, you have to explain or you have to define production cycle. What is production cycle? Because it may be asked in one mark question, that's why I have written here. Production cycle is the time period between the arrangement of raw material and conversion of raw material into finished goods is called production cycle. मतलब raw material खरीदने से लेकर उसको finished goods में convert करने तक जो time period है, it may be 2 days, 3 days, 5 days, we are not talking about the number of days. Here we are talking about the process of converting raw material into finished goods. Whatever time period they are taking, that time period is called production cycle. It is the time period between the arrangement of raw material, means procurement of raw material. Pehle raw material arrange karna, procure karna. After procuring raw material, it is converted into finished goods. Jab wo finished goods mein tayar ho jaye, us peech ke us pure duration ko, that duration is called production cycle. Now we have to explain about the working capital. If Production cycle is lengthy and complicated, then we need more working capital. On the other hand, if production cycle is simple, short and simple, then less working capital is required. Very simple explanation is there. In case of factors affecting working capital, only you need to learn points: nature and type of business, size of business, production cycle, nature and type of business. In case of manufacturing type of business, We need to purchase raw material. We need to set up plant and machineries for converting raw material into finished goods. That's why more working capital is required. Whereas in case of trading units, in trading based units, there is no need to purchase raw material. There is no need to set up plant and machineries. That's why less working capital is required. Second angle or second point of view, if business trend is based on capital intensive production technique, means machineries are more used and labors are less, then more working capital is required. And if business trends are based on labor intensive production technique, then less working capital is required. Size of business, if business unit is of large size, then more working capital is required. And if size of business unit is small, then less working capital is required. Production cycle, first of all, definition of production cycle, it is the time period between the arrangement of, means right from the procurement of raw material and conversion of raw material into finished goods. That duration is called production cycle. If production cycle is lengthy and complicated, then more working capital is required. And if, on the other hand, production cycle is short and simple, then less working capital is required. Fourth point is credit policy. Credit policy. Now, try to understand from this example. Suppose you are a businessman and you are purchasing goods from supplier and then selling goods to customer. Now, first of all, we are taking purchase transactions. If you are purchasing goods from supplier on cash basis, first part we are taking purchasing goods from supplier. If you are purchasing goods from supplier on cash basis means you are purchasing goods and immediately you are making payment. So if you are doing transactions with supplier on cash basis, immediately you are making payment, in that case you need more working capital. Working capital includes cash also, so more working capital you need. But this first point. Second, but if you are purchasing goods from supplier on credit basis, then you need less working capital. This is the first part of this answer. अगर आप supplier से आपने ये principle बना रखा है कि आप जब भी goods खरीदेंगे अपने business के लिए cash basis पे, इसका मतलब है आपको तुरंत हर वक्त cash होना चाहिए आपके पास. Every time you must have cash in order to purchase goods, means you need more working capital. और अगर आपको ऐसा credit facility मिल जाती है, उधार खरीदने की वो मिल जाती है सप्लायर से, तो आप उधार खरीद सकते हैं, पेमेंट करने की जरूरत नहीं है, बाद में पेमेंट कर सकते हैं. इट मीन्स इन दैट सिचुएशन यू नीड लेस वर्किंग कैपिटल. सिमिलरली नाउ यू आर सेलिंग गुड्स टू कस्टमर. थर्ड पॉइंट, अगर आप कस्टमर को उधार बेचते हैं, उधार तो बेच रहे, पैसा तो नहीं आ रहा है, बट यू नीड टू मेंटेन स्टॉक, सफिशियंट स्टॉक इन योर शॉप, वो तो आपको खरीदना पड़ेगा. यू आर सेलिंग गुड्स ऑन क्रेडिट to the customer, but at the same time you are not getting cash, but at the same time you have to maintain sufficient stock at your shop, in your shop. So if you are selling goods to customer on credit basis, then more working capital is required. आप वस्तु उधार बेचते जा रहे हैं तो दुकान तो ऐसे धीरे धीरे खाली हो जाएगी, तो आपको sufficient stock तो maintain करना पड़ेगा, वो तो आपको खरीदना पड़ेगा. That's why we need more working capital if we are selling goods to customer on credit, then we need more working capital. हम अगर उधार बेच रहे कस्टमर को, उस केस में हमारे पास कैश ज़्यादा अवेलेबल होना चाहिए ताकि हम अपनी दुकान के लिए, अपने बिजनेस के लिए जो भी स्टॉक है, फिनिश गुड्स है, वो खरीद सके. एंड ऑन द अदर हैंड, लास्ट पॉइंट, इफ़ वी आर सेलिंग गुड्स टू कस्टमर ऑन कैश बेसिस, मतलब हमारे बिजनेस में नो क्रेडिट पॉलिसी है फॉर कस्टमर्स, मतलब कस्टमर का उधार नहीं बेचेंगे. इट मींस इंस्टेंटली, इमीडिएटली वी आर गेटिंग कैश. इन दैट केस वी नीड लेस वर्किंग कैपिटल, क्योंकि हमें, हम जो भी वस्तु बेचते हैं उसका पैसा हमें तुरंत मिल जाता है, तो हमें अलग से पैसा रखने की जरूरत नहीं है. तो इफ़ वी आर सेलिंग गुड्स टू कस्टमर ऑन कैश बेसिस, देन लेस वर्किंग कैपिटल इज रिक्वायर्ड. दिस इज अबाउट क्रेडिट पॉलिसी, फोर्थ पॉइंट. एंड लास्ट वन इज ऑपरेटिंग एफिशिएंसी. ओरली आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग ऑपरेटिंग एफिशिएंसी. इफ मैनेजर इज एफिशिएंट, इफ टॉप लेवल मैनेजमेंट इज एफिशिएंट, इफ दे आर एबल टू, एफिशिएंट मींस दे आर एबल टू यूटिलाइज ऑल द रिसोर्सेज एट ऑप्टिमम लेवल, मींस दे आर एबल टू अर्न मैक्सिमम प्रॉफिट विद मिनिमम एफर्ट्स, इन दैट केस लेस वर्किंग कैपिटल इज रिक्वायर्ड. If manager or top level management are efficient, they are able to utilize all, efficient means they are able to utilize all the resources in the best possible manner at optimum level, means they are able to earn maximum profit with minimum cost. It means they, in such case, they need less working capital. But on the other hand, if managers are not efficient, they are not able to utilize all the resources at maximum level, means optimum level, means wastage increases, in that case they need more working capital. In simple language, two line, if manager is efficient, they, in that case business needs less working capital. If manager is not efficient, they need more working capital. So this is the explanation about the factors affecting working capital. Now topic of working capital is completed. Now any doubt you can ask.